الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت ذي العزة والجبروت الحمد لله ذي الفضل والكرم ذي العزة والنعم الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام عزيز لا يضام قهار لا يرام وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما أما بعد يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون ويبليه Fear Allah as He should be feared, and die not except on a state of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, grant us this great gift to die on a state of Islam. Allahumma ameena ya rabbil alameen. Amma ba'd. The journey in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the journey to detect the real objective in the life of the believer. Because when someone is facing this life, and facing difficulties, he only has one thing, is how to get rid of the difficulty that he has without thinking in a profound way what this difficulty means for him and how he should have set his objective to get out of these difficulties. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَأَيُّوبَ إِذْ نَادَ رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّحِيمُ Ayyub, behold, he invoked, he called upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, harm hath touched me, and you are the most merciful. And in this day is a great journey. And you ask yourself, does Ayyub, he's complaining when he's saying, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this harm has touched me, or Ayyub is invoking for a help. And when subhanAllah, when someone is facing a difficulties, is usually people they complain, وَيَجْزَى وَيَهْرَى and then all what he is doing is like questioning why this is happening to me. And if you look at Ayyub alayhi salam, he called it dhur and it's harm. And the question is, what was the harm that touched Ayyub? Because in this story, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it for the whole world to be a guide for us. Of understanding, a guide how to set our objectives. Because when you look at the story of Ayyub, as Ahlul Tafsir, they say that he has, mashallah, plenty of wealth, a lot of children, great family, and he has abundance of wealth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him to take part of his wealth, and then all of his wealth, and then his children, and everyone left for him, only his wife, his spouse. And it was a trial for everyone. It was a trial for Ayyub. And Ayyub, the example of the trial, because subhanAllah, he was tested in his nafs. He was tested in his children. He was tested in his family. He was tested in his wealth. He was tested in his friends. Because those friends of his around him all the time, when it happened to him this problem, they all left Ayyub, even though he's the Prophet of Allah. Because the question mark saying, if Ayyub was good, maybe he was like what he's appearing for us, what he's saying, doesn't really reflect what he has in his heart. Maybe Ayyub was a bad person in his heart. Maybe Ayyub wasn't sincere. That's why he's enduring all this difficulty. That's why he's been inflected with all this difficulty. As long when he's saying people, but he's Rasulullah, he's Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's another question mark. Did Ayyub, alayhi salam, invoking Allah that the touch, the inflict, or the harm that is touching him, ya Allah, help me. If this help came because of what he happened to him, it's not Ahlul Tafsir, they say an average of 7 years, because he had even, alayhi salam, the harm to touch his body, to the point that they left him or took him out of the town, so he was at the outskirts of the town, that where he resided. They say by actually the dumpsters. And the dhur that our Ayyub alayhi salam, as Ahlul Tafsir talking about, is something that we might not think about. Because It was something that is what given him life, what given him tranquility, what given him the real joy. It is the connection with Allah. It is his tongue and his heart. When the disease comes to touch those, that's when he cried out, Ya Allah. And the other question, why Ayyub said, Arhamur Rahimin? He didn't invoke any other name of Allah. Oh Ya Allah, the healer. Oh Ya Allah, who had the power of over all things. Because in fact, when we think of a dhur, it's not something that you invoke Allah as your right to be taken away from you, as your right to be relieved from this dhur, as your right for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take it away or to remove it away. No. Because the dhur, when it inflicted on us, is a state of justice of Allah. Because of his absolute will, subhanahu wa ta'ala, absolute just will, that when inflicted of us, it is something that we don't have the right to ask Allah to take it away. Because it's like someone who's in prison for a violation that he did, he will not say, I am here, mazloom, I am transgressed. No, you have it because of the thing. You're being guilty, and it's being proven that you're being guilty, and also you acknowledge that you're being guilty. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala, ma asabaka min shay, or min dhur, whatever, min sayyi'a, whatever bad thing happened to you, whatever ill thing happened to you, is because of what you did. Wa ma asabakum min musiba, fabima kasabat aydikum, wa ya'fu an kathir. Whatever befallen you is because of what you earn yourself. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives a lot. So what is inflicted us after a lot of forgiveness, after a lot of rahmah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when Ayyub alayhi salam invoked Allah with the attribute, Ya Arhamar Rahimi, because Ya Allah is not my right. It's not a right from me for you, or right that I have on you to relieve me, to have saved me. No, it is rahmah from Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he comes with his bounty to take away the difficulty that you have. Really, we don't have any right with Allah to say why. Because what the problem that we have, the cause of it is us. And that's what Ayyub alayhi salam saying. Therefore, when you think of this ayah, and we have to get a long journey in it, you'll ask, what is then the harm? When you look at it from the point of view of the Sharia, when you look at the point of view of your journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the harm or the dhur, it is like a tool to purify us. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful intent, either to elevate your ranks or to beautify your record for the Day of Judgment. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you better opportunity of rahmah in the Day of Judgment. He put you in ibtila. And that comes what is the cure when you have the dhur in the sabr, patience. When you have patience, that's the cure that you are enduring. And the natija of that will be the faraj. The relief comes as bushra from Allah. Bushra not to help you to get you, because maybe when you were in difficulty, your record of hasanat is higher than after when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took away the difficulty. Therefore, the faraj, the relief comes to you as subhanallah, faraj, as glad tidings from Allah that is arhamur rahimin. That glad tidings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from you the worship of the sabr. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the dhur will not inflict it on us more than we can bear, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قَالَ الْأَنْبِيَاءُ وَشَدُّ بَلَاءً. Well, those who endure the most of difficulties, or the greatest of the difficulty, are the anbiya. And the anbiya comes after the difficulty. It's not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punishing them as people they think. It's actually a reward from Allah. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was said about Ibrahim alayhi salam, after he's been submitted to slaughter his own son, قَالَ وَكَذَلِكَ نَجَزِي. إِنَّ كَذَلِكَ نَجَزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ. This is how we reward the great doers, how we reward the muhsineen. You say, Ya Allah, you are subhanak. You have Ibrahim to endure the difficulty to slaughter his son, and you call it reward for muhsineen. Yes. Therefore, we ask ourselves, is the dhur that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it for us a trial, and is inflicted for us with all justice, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in the hadith, قَالَ مَاذٍ فِيَّ حُكْمُكَ عَدْلٌ فِيَّ قَضَاكَ. Pass in me your decree, and your decree on me, Ya Allah, is all just. Therefore, we ask ourselves, what will be, should be the objective of the sabr? If you're enduring sabr, Well, a difficulty inflicted on you, what should be the objective of it? It is the objective for Allah to save you from the difficulty or other thing. That's where, subhanAllah, the subtle thing in the Quran that help us to be firm on the path. And with this understanding, we can face any difficulties. But this is, of course, with the help of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, the objective of the sabr is to make a separation between the state that you are in with the difficulty and your relation with Allah. Because the inflict, when the difficulty attack you, the first thing, someone lose the connection. That's it. He cannot even think. He doesn't have any focus in salah. Filled with anxiety. He cannot even, he doesn't know how many rak'ah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, the sabr comes here as objective to separate between the state that you're in of difficulty and your connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because if you lose the connection, you lose your positive thinking of Allah, you use the ma'iyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Musa alayhi salam, when he was going to face one of the biggest difficulties to face Fir'aun, what did he ask? He asked for set of help of Allah to keep him in connection. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli waj'al li wazira min ahli Harun akhi ujdud bihi azri wa ashriku fi amri. Why all this? Oh Allah, open the breast or expand the breast of my chest in a way to feel like strong. Oh Allah, untie my tongue so I can express myself, and help me to have my brother to be with me to help me. And all of that, why? قَالَ كَيْ نُسَبِّحَكَ كَثِيرًا وَنَشْكُرَكَ وَنَذْكُرَكَ كَثِيرًا. This is, Ya Allah, for us to be in connection with you for tasbih, to be in connection with you with dhikr. Why? Because when you hold yourself on dhikr, therefore the difficulty cannot shake you. The difficulty as a trial come to shake you down, to put you down, for people to need to step on you. And this is when you stand strong with the dhikr of Allah, with the connection of Allah. When you are in difficulty, then you will not ask Allah to give you relief. Ask Allah to keep you in connection with Him. He didn't say, Musa alayhi salam, oh Allah, don't help me to go to Fir'aun. He told him what are the tools, what were weapon to help him be entitled to be in connection with Allah. كَيْ نَذْكُرَكَ نُسَبِّحَكَ كَثِيرًا وَنَذْكُرَكَ كَثِيرًا. What he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, later on, قال, اذهبا, you and your brother, بِآيَاتِي وَلَا تَنْيَا فِي ذِكْرِي. تَنْيَا فِي ذِكْرِي, don't be tired or disconnect from my dhikr, because my dhikr, my remembrance, my connection is the way to keep you firm, is the way to keep you strong, is the way to keep you facing the difficulty. Because there's no such a thing, life without difficulty. There's no such a thing, life without trial. No difficulty will be in general, not in this dunya. Therefore, when someone is always trying to get rid of difficulty, he's really trying something that is not normal in our life. What you need to try, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you make the separation. Like Ayub, he found the serenity, he found the tranquility even after he lost everything. But when the disease came to touch the tool that connected with Allah, that's when he cried out. And it's not my right, Ya Allah. It's you, Rahma, who helped me to be relieved from this. To help me, Allah, to be connected with you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Qasas, also about Musa wa Harun. قَالَ بِآيَاتِنَا أَنْتُمَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَكُمَ الْغَالِبُونَ. With my ayat, with my miracle, with my way of revelation, with you on holding fast to Allah, with the Quran, with the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and holding them, you will be with everyone that follow you, الغالبون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the help. When Sulaiman alayhi salam, he's facing, and he's the greatest king that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him, the greatest of the kingdom. When he asked for the throne of the queen of Saba to be brought to him as an evidence for the queen of Saba to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ifrit of the jinn, this big jinn, ifrit, he said, I will bring it to you even before you finish your meeting. And the one who had the knowledge of the kitab, he said, I will bring it to you in the blink of the eye. When he saw that, this is a power. This is a power to have a whole throne being transferred from a town, from Yemen today, to Palestine today, to Al-Quds, in the blink of eye, is a power. what Sulaiman alayhi salam did to remind us. This is another type of trial who going to shake you, make you feel arrogant, showing up. You can't control the whole world. You can't control everything. قَالَ هَذَا مِنْ فَضْلِ رَبِّي لِيَبْلُوَنِي أَأَشْكُرُ أَمْ أَكْفُرُ. This is a bounty of Allah to test me, to be grateful or to be someone who ungrateful. In the position of power, there's also the trial. So it's not the trial of difficulty. Actually, one of the biggest trials is to have money in your pocket more than you can bear. Why? Because you can think that you control everything. You can think that you reach everything. You can think that you can have everything. But you cannot have everything. Because by being ungrateful, you lost everything. You lost that separation that you need to do between, and this is, as we say, the objective of the sabr. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about Yunus to remind us that your connection with Allah, it is the way how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala come to for your help. Not we trying to get rid of the problem that we have of difficulties. Maybe the difficulty that you are enduring is the reason for you to get to Jannah. Then have to inquire from Allah the state of tranquility with the dhikr of Allah, not with what you have be in your hand. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala, أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُ الْقُلُوبِ. The qulub, the heart find their rest and their peace with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he reminds us, when Yunus alayhi salam trapped in the stomach of the whale, and Allah saved him, what was the main pillar of the save? What has as a credit Yunus alayhi salam, قَالَ لَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ. لولا أنه كان من المسبحين للبث في بطنه إلى يوم يبعثون. If it wasn't from those who celebrate the praises of Allah, exalted Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will have stayed there till the day of judgment. So he will be resurrected from that place. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought him out and he favored him to send him to his people again, and they accepted him. And look, the great maqam of Yunus alayhi salam. Why? Because to teach us, your objective of sabr is not relief. Of course, we want al-afiyah. We want the ease. But how you get the shortcut to the ease? The shortcut to the ease? How you get the shortcut to the relief? You find the relief even if you are in the midst of problem. Why? Because the relief is in this chest. You know the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam for 23 years of jihad, when he was relief in his sadr, أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ. Therefore, when you think as it as a believer, if you just reset our objective, reset our vision, to be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you'll be firm on your path. And then you think of the relief of the faraj, when the faraj comes, the faraj, many people, they will be think that it's too late. It's taken long to come, long time. If you have this understanding, the faraj is not to save you from your difficulty. The faraj is glad tidings from you that Allah accepted you. The faraj is glad tidings from you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is elevating you. The faraj is a glad tidings of rahmah from Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you. Because when the faraj comes, Allah had the power to relieve you, to help you. Look, Ayyub alayhi salam, when he called up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helped Ayyub. قَالَ أُرْكُضْ بِرِجْلِكَ هَذَا مُغْتَسَلٌ بَارِدٌ وَشَرَابٌ. The whole dunya could not help Ayyub. Ayyub alayhi salam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will for him to help him, he said, stamp with your feet on the ground. Just laying down and hit the ground with your feet. A spring come out, drink from it and wash. And it was, that's it. So when his wife came and he looked at Ayyub, told him, did you see a man here who was laying down? She told him, I am Ayyub. She told him, no, I'm talking about the man. He said, I am me, Ayyub, your husband. Farkur bi rijlik. It's very simple. Allah had the power to take all your problem. Allah had the power to make you billionaire. Allah had the power to make you whatever you wish in the dunya. But that's not the point. The point is make your objective to be connected with Allah. That's how you find your peace. That's how you find the tranquility. That's how you find your path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very simple. In all the Quran, if you read it, the relief of Allah came in a very simple way. Allah didn't have the power to do it from the beginning. No, He keeps you in the difficulty because he wants you to bring you up. Are you not asking every day for the Jannah? And then the trial is coming, is that your path for the Jannah? Are you not asking already Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase your khushu' for those who are really serious about that? It's not the difficulty that you find is an answer of your dua. Therefore, when you make your hadaf for your objective and you make your sabr, don't make your sabr like you're pressing yourself to hold, is like a ceiling is going to fall on you. Don't make the sabr to make have better connection. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. قَلَا يَا أَيُّ الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا اسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُونِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونِ. Remember you, I remember you. Be grateful to me and don't be great and grateful. And then how to do this? Help yourself with patience, which is the sabr. What is his objective? To connect it and with the salah. Therefore, when you say, how can someone trust to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What are the ingredients of the trust? It is to strive to be patient. Second, to strive to be always in a state of dhikr. Third, which is the most important, to always have a positive thinking of Allah. Al-husnu al-dhanni billahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I would like to finish this first part of the khutbah with one of the foundation of everything. The foundation of art, where we're talking about. The foundation of the help of Allah. Because if you do everything and Allah is not with you, you are subhanahu wa ta'ala as like someone calling وَقَالَ وَمَا دُعَاءُ الْكَافِرِينَ إِلَّا فِي ظَلَاءٍ. You make dua and your dua is lost in the air. It doesn't have any direction because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala locked his door on us. And the only foundation is to hold on the truth, to stand with the truth, to stand with justice. If you lean to the wrong, Allah turn away from you. One of Imam Ahmed, rahimahullah, he came to him, قَالُوا أَلَا تَرَى أَنَّ الْبَاطِلَ قَدْ ظَهَرَ عَلَى الْحَقِّ. Don't you see, ya Imam, that the falsehood is prevailing over the truth? He said, no, never and never. But this has only happened عندما القلوب تنتقل من الهدى إلى الضلال. When the heart, by fear, by cowardice, by fear of the unknown, by lack of iman, by the disconnect from Allah, they turn from guidance to misguidance. That's when it's prevailed in every one of us. And he said, with Izzah rahimahullah, قَالَ وَقُلُوبُنَا لَازِمَةٌ وَقُلُوبُنَا بَعْدُ لَازِمَةٌ. But our hearts are still firm on the truth. If we want the help of Allah, first we need to strive to stand with the truth, to fight for the truth, to be with the truth, to follow the truth, and then set the objective of your sabr. When you have a difficulty, ask Allah to help you be connected to Him and always have positive thinking. That's when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put you in the rank of the salihin, as Yusuf and Sulaiman in the end of their life. قال وألحقنا بالصالحين أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى. أما بعد, all of us, dear brother and respected sister, in every day we facing these difficulties, these troubles. And in the Quran we have the medicine, but sometimes you don't know, there's on the shelf a lot of medication and you have a certain disease, you don't know which one. We need someone to point to you to the right medicine. Those are the inheritors of the MBA, the scholars, those people of trust, those who know and act upon what they know. But also in the Quran, if you do your own reading, if you ask. Therefore, in every time when you have facing to a difficulty, what you going to hold? What is the first step? Your first step, dear brother, is to hold first on the truth. Hold first. وَعَتَسِمُ بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ. Look, there's Hablillah wa atasimu billah. The Hablillah is the way of Allah, in the Quran, in the deen. So hold on the truth and then bring the sabr, then bring the dhikr. The first thing that you do, as Imam Ahmad said, hold, let your heart be holding all the truth. Because anything else is perishable. Anything else you're going to hold to it is going to fall. Why? It will not last. This is remind me of the story of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Hunayn, when there is this lot of spoils that he gave to everyone except to the Ansar. He gave to the Bedouin, he gave to the Arab, he gave the people of Mecca, but the Ansar, they didn't get anything. And it was a test, very difficult test. The Ansar that did everything for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they gave him the home, and everyone, as he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, قال لو قلتم لصدقتم ولا صدقتم نصرناك وقد كذبوه etc. وأويناك وجئت إلينا طريدا فأويناك. And all of that, the Prophet said, if you say it, yes, you say it. But subhanAllah, the nafs is weak. How come the Prophet gave to everybody? Camels and goats, but not them. And look what he said, قال أوجدتم في أنفسكم شيئا في لعاعة من الدنيا. You have something against me because of something that I gave from the dunya? He said, I gave them because those people, they don't have strong iman. I gave them that to increase their iman. But for you, I have entrusted you to your iman. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't you want that everyone want with the goat, take the camel as a goat, and you go back to with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is, we have the choice in every day in our life. And you have a choice, your first step, are you going to get the dunya, goat and camels and money, or you go to the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the result is in Allah surah rahma in al-ansar. And he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in one riwayah, he said, you're going to see a lot of trouble after me. Fasbiru, have patience, I'll meet you by the hawl. And I'll ask every one of you, would you like to meet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by your hawl? So that's what we need to implement. If you make your first step to his way, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and leave the dunya out, leave anything that will distract you. It doesn't mean that you're going to deprive yourself from it. No, hold on Allah. Allah will bring it to you as a part of the package. Why? Because you want to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to be firm on his way. And shower us, our heart with taqwa. And pour on us sabr. اللهم افرغ علينا صبرا وثبت اقدامنا برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين اللهم اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار اللهم ارنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وارنا الباطل باطلا ووفقنا لاجتنابه برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين واخر دعوانا ان الحمد لله رب العالمين واقم الصلاه يرحمكم الله